Today we're working on a concrete installation job with radiant snowmelt heating cables to be installed. With me today is Tom Fitzgerald from Able Concrete. Hi, Tom.
Hi.
Thank you so much for coming out. We're going to be talking about some of the things that you need to look out for and some of the things that you need to take care of while you're planning to do your concrete install. And then we'll also be showing you putting the concrete in and all the electrical that has to go along with it, laying the cables out, that sort of stuff. All right, Tom, can you tell us about the job in a whole, is what's going to be happening this week here at the house?
Sure. We're going to be removing the existing patio, installing a radiant heat system to melt snow and make the patio available for year-round use, installing a new decorative concrete patio, and then installing a hot tub on a portion of the patio.
Well, we're here on day two, and you can see that we've got all the old concrete, all the reinforcement, all that stuff has been taken away, and they brought fresh new gravel in here to give it a nice level feel. But what we're going to be doing today is putting down the insulation and the reinforcement metal to install the wiring. Tom and I are taking a look at the roll here of the heating wire, and we're looking at the mesh that the wire is attached to. What would you say, Tom, that you need to do as a concrete contractor to work with something like this?
Well, the mesh has a relatively small opening, so we're going to change our typical concrete mix to use a smaller aggregate, about a 3/4 inch minus aggregate, so we know it'll travel through the mesh and make it down to the bottom portion of the slab.
All right, what we've done is we flipped the mat over, the roll over, and there's a couple things on here I'd like to bring up. The first thing you want to do is make sure they're the correct voltage, and there will be a voltage sticker on the mat itself to let you know 240 or 120, whichever one it is. Also on the mat, there's going to be a couple of labels on the mat that are telling you what the ohms values are, what the cable lengths are, that sort of stuff. That information you do not want to bury in the concrete. You want to take them off and give them to the homeowner so they can complete their warranty card and turn that in. We know that this mesh really doesn't provide a lot of reinforcements, but what does that mean for you as a concrete contractor?
We'll install a bit more rigid steel reinforcement. In this case, we'll use a 6-gauge wire mesh to support this system and reinforce the concrete.
Now we can take a look at the setup here. We can see that we have reinforcement bars installed, and the reinforcement bars are sitting on concrete blocks. The concrete blocks are on top of an insulating layer. The concrete blocks are under the reinforcement bars to keep them propped up into the middle of the pour. When we pour the concrete, we don't want the cables to go all the way to the ground. We want them to be in the middle of the slab. So we pour the concrete goes through, and the cables stay right in the middle of the slab. All right, before you do anything with the electric mats, what you want to do is you want to make sure that you test them. So what we have here is we have a mega ohm meter, and this mega ohm meter should be used now to make sure that the mats are good, and the mega ohm meter should be used constantly while the concrete is being poured over the mats to make sure that the mats are not being damaged by any of the tools or people using the tools while the concrete is going down. So what I'm going to do now is we need to test these to see if we have any connectivity between the cores and the ground. You want to make sure you have no connectivity between either core or ground to make sure that your mat is good. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to attach the ground here to the ground wire. They're going to take the probe here and attach it to the black wire, and I set it for 500 volts, and I'm going to hit measure. And what I'm getting is an OF, which means overflow, which is exactly what you want to get. It means it's infinity. The two wires do not see each other in the mat. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to go along the other conductor, the red one, and make sure I get the same reading. And I'm getting overflow on here, which means I have infinity between the red core and the ground. When you're doing this test is, as I said, 500 volts, so you need to be careful. The last thing you want to do is grab any of these wires right now because there's a chance of you getting shocked. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to test to make sure I have the correct ohms across the two conductors. So I move the ground over to one of the conductors, move the red over here, and I press test, and I write the number down on the warranty card. If you look closely, you can probably notice that there's a gap here between the electric cables. The electric cables, you want to make sure, are never touching each other because they could overheat in that area. So we always try to keep them at 3-inch spacing. But down the middle here, you can actually see where the spacing is greater than 3 inches. And the reason why is because we're going to be pouring the concrete completely over the slab and then coming back and cutting the expansion joint through the middle of this. You can do it one of two ways. You can pour it and then cut it, the expansion joint, or you can put a board with some felt in between before you pour, and then you have two monolithic slabs. What we want to end up with are two monolithic slabs that are not attached to each other in any way, and that means we can't have the wires going from one slab to the other. That's why you see a clean break down the middle. All right, now we're down in the electrical control room, and you can see I'm right here in front of the circuit breaker box. Well, the circuit breaker box is going to be sending two lines of power out. A 120 line for the controls and a 240 line for the rolls out in the concrete. The area, as it gets bigger, the more amperage it takes, so that's why this space is being done in 240. So if we take a look at our conduit coming out of the breaker box, we can see we have two lines. This line right here is going over to the controller, and that's 120. The controller, when we actuate the controller, will send 120 over to the relay box to close the relays. Well, if we look back over here, we can see there's another conduit coming out of the breaker box, and that's 240. The 240 going directly over to the relays. So what happens is the controller tells the relays to turn on and off with 120 volt, and the relays will send the 240 volt out to the mats, and that's being supplied by the circuit breaker. Here we can see actually what is used to stamp the concrete. Tom, tell us about what this is.
We actually use a stamp from Butterfield Systems that is a 12-inch wide wood grain, and it gives the impression of a wood deck. It typically takes us about an hour to stamp the surface out after we've struck it off.
Come to the end of another day, and we can see that we've accomplished a lot today. When we started this morning, this area was just cables and rebar, and now we have concrete poured and we have it stamped and stained. Well, here we are a couple months later, and it's starting to get cold out, but what you can see is we have a finished product here down in this area. If you have any more questions about heating your patio, heating your driveway, that sort of stuff, feel free to check us out at warmlyyours.com. Thanks for watching.